Okay, the next is Mr. Chandra Sekar, Dr. Chandru. The Chandru is was my student before. You Chandru is here?
I'm here, sir.
Okay, Chandra. Chandra, can you present your work? I think ID
Good
559, influence of seawater treatment on mechanical and dynamic mechanical property of flux and sugar pump fiber. Sugar pump was done with me now, but maybe you have done flux, so my names are included. Anyway, so okay, please, you have 10-15 minutes.
Good afternoon to all present here, and especially to my special good afternoon to Professor Sapuan, because I have worked with him for during my PhD for 3 years, and it has been a quite good experience, Professor, working with you. So I'll be happy to present my research in front of you. So I'll share my screen and start presenting. Just give me a minute. I'm sorry that I couldn't send it before the presentation, but I hope I can send it to the secretary. So good afternoon to one and all present here again, and I hope my screen is visible.
Yes.
Okay, so I'll make it to full screen. Is it in full screen mode?
Yes, now it's very good.
Okay. Thank you. So the title is on assessing the influence of seawater on the mechanical properties as well as on water absorption characteristics and morphological changes with flax and sugar palm based hybrid composites. So biofibers, as we know, that it has been in many forms and in many types. So they have been used as fiber reinforcements in polymer composites. And in Malaysia, during my time with Professor Puan and UPM, and along with Dr. Javed, also who is in my research group, who was part of my research group at the time, I happened to work with sugar palm fibers. Sugar palm is naturally found in many places in Asia and in Malaysia as well. So one advantage with this fiber, especially the Egypt fiber, is it's naturally in woven form available like coconut sheet, like what we have in coconut fibers. So it's a low cost reinforcement compared to flax and other fibers like kinaf, so which you will have to buy it at a high cost and have to process it. So this doesn't require processing. So that's one of the advantages. And especially when it comes to application part, we have been using it in construction, marine, and other medium strength applications. So here, what I'm trying to do is to assess the degradation in mechanical and mechanical properties and morphological changes through seawater treatment. So the first objective is to find out how, if I vary the stacking sequence in the hybrid composite, how the composites respond to mechanical loads like tensile load, short beam load, and then I have also done a dynamic mechanical analysis to find out what happens to the hybrid composites on exposure to seawater. So the composites were fabricated with the help of compression molding technique, simple compression molding technique, and specimens were immersed in water until saturation. So here we can see the water absorption characteristic. So the composites were immersed until up to nearly 1100 hours, which reaches almost the saturation state. So there are three types of water absorption behavior in a polymeric composite. So it would be Fickian, non-Fickian, or anomalous. So this follows a non-Fickian diffusion, where it almost has like two-stage absorption. So here you can see that until 72 hours, there is the first stage and followed by the second stage of absorption. So we can see here the maximum absorption percentage was nearly 8 to 20% by the time it was 504 hours. I'm so sorry for the disturbance here around the background noise, because I'm in the cabin, as I couldn't be somewhere else. Okay, I'm sorry for the disturbance around. So here, this.
I mean, it is fine. We can still hear you well, but.
Okay, I'm so sorry please, for the interruption here. Okay, so I just it can be observed that there is a maximum weight gain here at 5.4 hours, and after that it reaches saturation at nearly 1100 hours. So the interesting observation here is so the blue line here on the top indicates flax, and then the sugar pump. So when we make it into hybrid composite here, the moisture absorption decreases. So this is one good advantage that, and it also shows the compatibility between the two different fibers, because flax fiber has a unique identity, and sugar palm it appears in unique identity, and they are in different forms. Flax, I use it in unidirectional form, and sugar palm I used it in naturally woven form. So the compatibility of the different fibers also is one of the deciding factors for its physical care properties and mechanical properties. So this is one such observation we can take it as advantage.
Yeah, hello. Chandru?
I think you are muted.
Guys.
Sorry for the disturbance, sir. Okay, so I just wanted to continue with the DMA. And here, in case of DMA, we get three different plots. One is storage modulus versus temperature. The second plot is loss modulus versus temperature. And the third is damping factor or tan delta with respect to temperature. So each of them is going to tell the characteristic of the composites and its influence on the seawater. So here we can see that the storage modulus is representative of stiffness of the composite. So after the seawater treatment, we can see there is a drop in storage modulus. So this signifies that the stiffness of the composite is going to get affected. And in case of loss modulus, which is going to represent the dissipation energy of the composites, we can clearly see that all the seawater treated composites presented lower values, lower loss modulus. So on the other hand, in case of tan delta, which is the ratio of loss modulus to storage modulus, we can see that the damping has been different from each and every composite case. So for flax, the damping factor has increased, and for sugar palm, the damping factor has decreased. But when it comes to the hybrid composites, again, it depends on the stacking sequence. So this stacking sequence is about flax on the outer layers. So the core is formed by the sugar palm. And in this case, the sugar palm is the outer layers, and core material should be with flax. So we can see here the damping characteristics changes. And this is damping factor is also an indication of fiber matrix interfacial bonding. So the lower damping, better the fiber matrix interfacial bonding. So that's a significant observation. And here we can see the values that has been taken from the DMA. So the peak storage modulus is something that represents the stiffness at room temperature. So we can see significant differences in values, and it is always a lower value when the composites are being exposed to seawater. And the magnitude of drop in these peak storage modulus depends on the composite. So for the sugar palm, it is far lower value. But when it is being used with flax, obviously the values are slightly higher. And another observation from the seawater treatment is shifting of glass transition temperature. So here we can see that the glass transition temperature for untreated specimens are in the range of 72 to 74. But as it gets exposed to the seawater, we can see the slight shift in TG, and it is also visible here. So the shift in TG is also slightly visible. So these are all the consequences of the specimen being exposed to such harsh conditions for a long time. So and I would like to go on to the mechanical properties. So in case of mechanical properties, tensile test and short beam test has been done. So in case of tensile test, it can be seen that for sugar palm and the hybrid composites, the values are slightly lower. So that means it has impact on the tensile strength. And the observations on stiffness or Young's modulus is lower compared to the untreated or unexposed signal. Yeah, so this also corroborates with the DMA properties. In DMA also, the storage modulus decline with respect to the seawater treatment. So we can see visibly here what happens to the stiffness. And on the other hand, the tensile strain. So this tensile strain usually is lower, but as it becomes, as it is exposed to seawater, we can see here the values are slightly higher. This says the plasticization effects on the seawater treatment. So in one of the literature, I found that this tensile strain increase and as well as the stiffness decrease could be the indication for matrix plasticization effect. So the short beam test is usually a 3-point bending test with a smaller beam, smaller composite beam. So this value is literally the indication for the fiber matrix interfacial strength. So we can see here the values are dropping nearly to 30 to 40% compared to each individual composites. And for hybrid composites, the values are pretty dropping. The values are dropping more than 50% here. So this indication is, this is a severity indication of what will happen to the composites when they are being exposed to seawater. And to get with the morphological analysis, when the composites are subjected to short beam test with a 3-point bending, usually the failure occurs on the top face. So there is a crack and fiber matrix debonding. But as the specimens are exposed to seawater, in case of figure B, C, and D, we can see delamination. Other than fiber matrix debonding, there is delamination also. So this is one of the severities that can occur. So there could, in case of a composite laminate being exposed to seawater for a long time, we can see the deterioration effects, that is the lamina, the delamination can be, is evident from this. So these are all the consequences on why the mechanical properties are declining for the composites exposed to seawater. So to conclude, from my study, actually the seawater exposed composites presented inferior strength, lower stiffness, and increased tensile strain. And then from DMA, we could observe shift in glass transition temperature. And we also could see how the stacking sequence had an influence on mechanical properties and interfacial, interlaminar shear strength. So in the morphological analysis, apart from fiber matrix debonding, delamination was also observed. So this is one of the main phenomenon which could have caused the drop in the mechanical properties. So this is my conclusion. And these are all some references that have been used for literature. So thank you. Thank you to the panel.
Okay.